Right in front. This is me right here.
Iona Boseman never planned to be a part of history.
I wanted to be a secretary of week. I was doing that.
But at 35 years old, she launched an unexpected career at the Michoud Assembly Facility.
I had never heard of soldering.
She began in 1964 when women and minorities were just being welcomed into the plant. Working with electronics would become her life until she retired in 1996. Michoud was a bustling place as it turned out rockets for the Apollo program and later the space shuttle program. Things amped up greatly after President John F. Kennedy announced his ambitious plan.
I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving the goal before this decade is out of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the earth.
But for as exciting as the work was, it did come with a certain level of stress.
And I always tried to do my work perfect because I knew, you know, somebody's lives, people's lives was involved.
The majority of NASA's missions went off without any issues, but there were the rare times things went wrong. Boseman remembers getting the news about Apollo 13.
That was terrible. Oh, that was a terrible day. I can remember one of the inspectors running down the hall. It was a sad day that day.
Fortunately, that mission had a safe conclusion. She also remembers happier days, like the one 50 years ago when Apollo 11 lifted off as staffers at the plant gathered around a TV.
Your heart just went up with it, you know. You just felt real good, especially when it was successful.
She's grateful for her unexpected place in the history books and can only wonder what's next in the final frontier.
They've been to the moon, they can go further.
Danny Monteverdi, Eyewitness News.
I just want to hear the stories all day. As NASA sets its sights on Mars, Boseman suggests young people look into careers that could help with that mission.